Mr. President, I voted for you in 2016. I'm conservative, pro-life, and diabetic. I've had to dodge people who don't care about social distancing and wearing face masks. I thought you were doing a good job with the pandemic response until about May 1st. Then you took your foot off the gas pedal. Why did you throw vulnerable people like me under the bus?
Well, we really didn't, Paul. We've worked very hard on the pandemic. We've worked very hard. It came off from China. They should have never let it happen. And if you look at what we've done with ventilators and now, frankly, with vaccines, we're very close to having a vaccine. If you want to know the truth, the previous administration would have taken perhaps years to have a vaccine because of the FDA and all the approvals. And we're within weeks of getting it. You know, it could be 3 weeks, 4 weeks, but we think we have it. Johnson & Johnson, Pfizer, we have great companies, and they're very, very close. But we're very proud of the job we've done, and we've saved a lot of lives, a tremendous number of lives. A lot of people got it wrong. They talked about don't wear masks, and now they say wear masks, although some people say don't wear masks. I mean, you have a lot of different ideas. Some people say just leave it the way it is and don't do any shutdowns, and other people say do shutdowns. And I have my own views on that.
But what did you get wrong? You say a lot of people got things wrong. I mean, you mentioned China at the top right there. All through January and February, you were downplaying, by your own admission, the severity of the crisis, that you didn't want to panic people.
Not downplaying.
But let me just finish the question first.
Not downplaying. I don't want to drive our nation into a panic. I'm a cheerleader for this nation. I'm the one that closed up our country. I closed it up long before any of the experts thought I should, and saved hundreds of thousands of lives.
If you believe it's the president's responsibility to protect America, why would you downplay a pandemic that is known to disproportionately harm low-income families and minority communities?
Yeah. Well, I didn't downplay it. I actually, in many ways, I upplayed it in terms of action. My action was very strong.
Did you not admit to it yourself, saying
that you... because what I did was, with China, I put a ban on. With Europe, I put a ban on. And we would have lost thousands of more people had I not put the ban on. So that was called action, not with the mouth, but in actual fact. We did a very, very good job when we put that ban on. Whether you call it talent or luck, it was very important. So we saved a lot of lives when we did that. If we didn't close the country, look, we all created together. You helped everybody. The fact is, we created the greatest economy in the history of the world. Best employment numbers for African American, Asian American, Hispanic American, women, everything. The best employment, high school, no high school, college. We had the best economy we've ever had. 160 million people, almost, just short of 160 million people. We were never close. And then somebody comes in, and then somebody else, doctors, and they start talking about the pandemic and about closing. They want to close up our country. I said, wait a minute, we have the greatest country, the greatest economy, and it was coming together even in terms of unity, because it was so successful that people that weren't getting along were starting to get along, George. That's the way we solved that problem. But we had the greatest economy ever, and we have to close it. If I didn't close it, I think you'd have 2 million deaths instead of having the 185, 190, it's a terrible number.
And you were saying it was going to disappear.
What?
You were saying it was going to disappear.
It is going to disappear. It's going to disappear.
But not if we don't take action, correct?
No, I still say it. It's going to disappear, George. We're going to get back. We're not going to have studios like this. We have all of this empty space in between. I want to see people, and you want to see people.
I understand that you don't want to panic people. You said you want people to be calm. You've often talked about Winston Churchill and FDR, and they did reassure people. They were strong. They did keep people calm, but they also were straight. They said this war is going to be tough. It's going to be a real fight. We have to persevere.
So when Churchill was on the top of a building, and he said everything's going to be good, everything's going to be calm, and you have the Nazis dropping bombs all over London, he was very brave because he was at the top of a building. It was very well known that he was standing on buildings and they were bombing. And he says everyone's going to be safe. I don't think that's being necessarily honest, and yet I think it's being a great leader. But he said, you're going to be safe, be calm, don't panic. And you had bombers dropping bombs all over London. So I guess you could say that's not so honest, but it's still great leadership.
So do you think it's okay to be dishonest?
I'm not looking to be dishonest. I don't want people to panic, and we are going to be okay. We're going to be okay, and it is going away, and it's probably going to go away now a lot faster because of the vaccine. It would go away without the vaccine, George, but it's going to go away a lot faster.
Away without the vaccine?
Sure, over a period of time. Sure, with time, it goes away.
And many deaths.
And you'll develop herd, like a herd mentality. It's going to be herd developed, and that's going to happen. That will all happen. But with the vaccine, I think it will go away very quickly.
Got to take a quick
break. But I really believe we're rounding the corner.
You know, we have 4% of the world's population, more than 20% of the cases, more than 20% of the deaths.
Well, we have 20% of the cases because of the fact that we do much more testing. If we wouldn't do testing, you wouldn't have cases. You would have very few cases.